Good morning, fans, Privateer FX. Wild day in the end yesterday. Kind of pisses me off when I'm not at my desk and we have like a 7% bar in any currency. But I wasn't at my desk. What can I say? Turkey raised 300 basis points. As you all probably know, we moved down from 45 to a low of 453. The question now on everybody's mind is this enough to stem the tide? If you believe it is enough, you will sell through the lows today. So the low yesterday exactly was 453.86. Which happens to match up pretty well with 454.19 and 453.90 today. If you think Turkey's still screwed, you'll fade this. I have a feeling, just on value for valuation reasons, that this will stem the tide and dollar Turkey's going to head lower from here. So with that, we have to move on and see what the secondary consequences of that are. Should be risk on. That Turkish reversal plus a relatively dovish FOMC, although the FOMC is, I think, just as expected. But rates are below 3 now. So equities are higher, not through the roof or anything, but 27.25. We've got Turkey under control. We've got rates below 3. Normally, this spells risk on. So, what are we looking at? We are looking at commodity currencies then today. Is Aussie going to pop higher? No strong feeling on it, but it should. The best chart out here is Euro Aussie again. Stopped right on the 200-day. Euro-Aussie is a tough one. I mean, it's not really tough. You just kind of have to close your eyes and go with the flow. You can see it's a trendy little fucker. We've come down from 161. Now we're 154, 700 points, which is normally a lot in currencies. But you can see this is just the kind of way Euro-Aussie rolls. This move last May. 140 to 150, then back 150 to 146. There's loads of 5, 6, 700, 800 point moves. And plus, as you can see also, Euro Aussie typically reacts quite well to the 200 day. So 154.60, you can sell some Euro Aussie today. This will probably be driven by the Aussie side, I would guess. A new high in Aussie today will be through 75.85. It really doesn't get interesting, in a sense, out of this range until we break these 76.08 highs. So Aussie, buying Aussie against the dollar, buying Aussie against the euro, looks interesting today. It's cousin dollar CAD. Dead middle of the range. Hate to, you know, two birds on a wire. What do you want to do with dollar CAD? I think you just leave it alone. And let's see what oil is. 71.58. Let's come off a bit. Oil still. Oil doesn't get bearish until we get through 71 bucks. So we just leave dollar CAD alone. Let's look at dollar yen. Got smashed last night in Asia. Tricky little day yesterday in dollar yen. We were pleased that we got paid. Euro yen and dollar yen. Again, we weren't around for this move up back up to 110.30. That was a tricky one to sell, right? Because it went through the 200-day, back up through the 200-day, and now back down on its knees, with yields lower. I'm not sure what to do with euro yen or dollar yen here. Euro yen's made a new low. So if you're more longer term and you held your euro yen from yesterday, this looks like it's got a ways to go. No reason that euro yen should stop until we get to 120, 125.80. So, not sure. I guess this could be Italy driving this a little bit, but we're just going to leave euro yen and dollar yen alone today, and our main focus is going to be on the Aussie. As far as news today, the South African Reserve Bank has rates today. UK retail sales, that'll be some sort of nonsense volatility. It doesn't really mean too much, retail sales in the UK. And we have finance ministers in Europe meeting in Brussels. There may be some headlines from them. Existing home sales at 2:30 Swiss time. And it's Thursday, so jobless claims should be out there as well. We're going to keep it light. No super strong ideas here. We have a bias to buy this Aussie, but that's about it. But we're going to keep it light. Make sure we don't give back profits from yesterday. And wait for stronger setups, really. So be cool, and I will catch you in New York Open.